What's going on, guys? BouseFeenux here, and at long last, we are finally taking a look at our first ranged weapon, the bow. Now, full disclosure, I've never touched the ranged weapons in Monster Hunter. For one, before Monster Hunter World, I never felt like ranged weapons really belonged in a Monster Hunter game, although story-wise, they kind of make sense to have them, and secondly, all the previous Monster Hunter games I've played have been on handhelds, and the control schemes for ranged weapons were always really difficult to get used to, so I just stuck with what I was comfortable with, and if I didn't make this guide, that would still be the case, and trust me, I didn't know what I was missing. When I started this guide out, I was pretty determined to not like the bow, but the more that I played it, I found myself enjoying it so much that I decided to make a few different bows and a whole new set of high-rank Azure Rathalos armor, which you're seeing now. And a quick note on that, though, the set isn't exactly the best for bows, so don't just rush out and make it because you saw it in this video. I had to learn from my mistake, and I'll show you some better stuff near the end of the video. So, with that out of the way, let's talk about bow in Monster Hunter World. It's fluid, it has a ton of mobility, decent DPS, and is a pretty killer when it comes to applying status effects. It's also pretty easy to manage compared to bowgun weapons, and in our Discord, we've pretty much dubbed it to be the gateway between Blademaster and Gunner weapons. If you're like me, and you aren't sure if you want to dip into ranged combat, take a bow out on a few hunts and then see what you think. You might end up a believer like me. There are downsides to bow, as with any weapon though. Doing optimal damage requires fairly good monster anatomy knowledge, and if you've researched them enough, you can see where your shots will do the most damage on the body chart, as indicated by the little bullet icon with a star count next to it. 3 stars is most damage. You don't have to do this, and obviously you won't have this knowledge going into a fight for the first time if you're new, but it does help to arm yourself with the knowledge of where you can do, for sure, the most damage. Failing that, just keep shooting the monster in different parts until orange numbers start showing up. Aside from that, you'll need a hefty supply of coatings, which essentially serve as your different ammo types. Every bow has specific coatings available to it, and you can only carry a limited number of them on hunts, so that means 2 things. 1, you'll have to carry resources to make coatings out on hunts, or 2, you'll need to revisit the base camp to restock if you run out in the middle of a hunt. And I have to include this because someone had to tell me, you can buy coatings and different ammo at the stockpile provisions shop. I've never played ranged weapons, so I have always just completely ignored gunner materials. Now, if you're running out of coatings way before a hunt is over, this can also serve as a DPS check for you. That usually means that it's probably time for a more powerful version of the bow you're using, a different bow entirely, or you just need to make sure you're using your ammo efficiently and hitting the vulnerable parts of the monster. As for moveset, the bow is about as simple as they come. Hold L2 to aim and press R2 to shoot. It doesn't get any simpler than that, folks. To apply coatings, you can select them with the D-pad by pressing up and down and then press triangle to apply them. You can also press triangle again to take them off. Also, you don't have to take one coating off to apply another. You can just swip and swap. If you hold down R2, you'll charge up your shot to a maximum of 3 levels and deal a lot more damage. You'll know what level you're on by the number of arrows you fire after each shot. Level 1 is 1 arrow, level 2 is 2 arrows, and level 3 is, you guessed it, 3 arrows. Keep in mind that while charging the shot and holding it, you will drain your stamina, so watch out for that. If your stamina is too low, you won't be able to charge shots and you'll automatically let them go. If you'd rather spam shots, you can do that too. Shooting 3 uncharged shots in a combo chain will build you up to the level 3 charged shot. Pressing circle gives you the special shot, and its properties change depending on when you use it. From neutral, without doing anything, you get a quick shot of 3 arrows thrown out in a very wide fan with super short range. If you fire a charge shot at any level and then press circle, you'll get the power shot with considerably more damage and range, but the shots still fan out over a wide area. The higher the charge level of the preceding shot, the more powerful your power shot will be. I typically follow up my charge shots with a power shot if I can. If you dodge while aiming, you can perform a power shot immediately after the dodge as well. Now, this is where the bow's maneuverability comes into play, as you have special dodges that are available to you in your toolkit. So while aiming, if you dodge in a direction, you'll perform a charging sidestep, which allows you to charge a shot while dodging. This is a fantastic tool that, if used effectively, allows you to avoid damage while still keeping the pressure on. For this, I typically like to start my charge just as I'm about to dodge, and this puts me at level 3 charge shot by the time the dodge is finished. Also, immediately after dodging, if you press triangle, you'll perform a melee attack that does a surprising amount of damage. You can also mount monsters with this attack. Your big nuke attack, though, is the Dragon Piercer, which is performed by pressing triangle and circle at the same time. This is infinite and devastating, but it does have a very long charge time, and your aiming is restricted to a small cone in front of you. so make sure you're in a safe spot before using it. If the attack lands, though, it'll travel all the way through the monster, so you make sure you aim for the head through the tail for the best results and maximum damage. This is one of your most damaging options when the monster has been toppled or is otherwise incapacitated. Your last tool is what I like to call the big old bag of rocks. Pressing R2 in circle will launch a large bag of spiky boys in the air and they'll rain down on a monster. The damage from this attack isn't exactly spectacular, but it does do stun damage, and if you land it on the head enough, it'll knock a monster out. You can aim this kind of like a mortar if you hold L2, R2, and circle, then aim with the left thumbstick. Otherwise, it'll just land above the spot that you're aiming at. On a slope, you can slide into a charge shot, or if you jump, you can perform a melee attack by pressing triangle. This works the same as if you were to jump from a ledge. The last thing to note is that the bow is not a sniper rifle. It does have a maximum range. If you're too far from the monster, you'll get this helpful little prompt on your reticle that reminds you to get closer. If you're too far, sometimes your shots won't even connect. If they do, they'll probably do a lot less damage. But that is about it for bow combat mechanics. Let's talk about how coatings work, weapons, and armor recommendations, and all that fun stuff. When forging a new bow, there's a few things to take into consideration. Damage, affinity, and elemental effect are something you should take into account before making any weapon, but with bow, there's an added mechanic. As you look through the tree, you'll see that each bow has certain arrow coatings available to it, and you can see those on the card on the right-hand side of the screen. Arrow coatings work to apply various status effects, and when you make the bow, you can only use those arrow coatings, so make sure you have a couple of different weapons to choose from for different jobs and fighting different types of monsters. As a rule of thumb, you'll always have the close-range arrow coating in an infinite amount, but you should also try to make sure that your bow has the power coating, as it gives you a little bit more damage overall to your shots, and it gives your bow a bit more versatility. You may also notice that some bows have a large plus sign next to the coating on the crafting screen. As you can probably guess, this means that that specific coating type will be extra effective. Now, armor works a bit differently for ranged weapons than it did in previous games. In the older Monster Hunters, armor was divided into two separate classes, and you had a set for Blademaster and a set for Gunner. This was a huge turnoff for people because to use either weapon, they had to pretty much make two different sets. In Monster Hunter World, that is no longer the case. Everything is combined, so attack boost will work for your bow shots the same way it would work for a sword swing. That being said, there are a few skills you might want to look out for. Stamina skills like Stamina Surge and Marathon Runner will help keep your stamina up so you can fire more shots or perform more evasive maneuvers. The piercing shots and special ammo boost skills are pretty solid as well, as they increase your dragon piercer damage, and in conjunction with that, the power shot skill is pretty good too, which increases the attack power of your power shot arrows. Aside from those, the usual affinity skills, attack up skills, and evade skills are always solid choices. I do want to point out that generally with the way armor works in Monster Hunter World now, it's a lot easier to pick and choose which skills you want, so it's pretty hard to end up with a set that's absolutely useless. You don't really have to build armor the way you used to in the previous games, and that being said, there is always an optimal solution, but a lot of that depends on your weapon choice and playstyle. I just give these recommendations in these videos as a starting point to kind of give you an idea of what to look for. But that's basically it, guys. I think we pretty much covered just about everything you need to know to pick up a bow and start hunting with it. If you have additional questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, or even better, join my Discord by using the link in the description and get one of our many bow users to answer your questions. I also hang out there pretty frequently, so stop by and check us out. But before you go, if you enjoyed this video or just found it helpful, don't forget to leave a like down below and get subscribed if you're new here so that you never miss a new video. Until next time though, I'm BouseFeenux, I'll see you at the next one, and as always, thank you so much for watching.